What up, nerds? It's Jason here from Custom Cans, and it's been a while. We've been crazy busy over Christmas and New Year. Not really had time to shoot any videos or anything, but I missed you guys. Let's hang out. Let's hang out more often. Let's just do that. Today we have some Denon AH-D2000s, which we're going to be replacing the cable on. It looks like I think they've already got an aftermarket cable. This looks kind of aftermarket. But they've been sent in with a fancy cable, and we're gonna swap those over. So it'll give us a good chance to see how they're made, have a look inside. If you've got a pair of these that you need to repair, might be handy to see how they come apart, or if you want to recable them again. But anyway, it's something I've got to do. Might as well video it. Let's get on with the show. Alrighty then, let's have a butcher. So. These are pretty nice, aren't they? So you've got the wooden ear cups, metal yokes, quite nice hinges. Yeah, it all seems to be made out of metal. It's quite cold to the touch, so I'm assuming that's all metal. Nice action on the slider with Teflon runners on the inside to make it run super smooth. Yeah, nice bit of kit. So let's have a look. So inside here, you have a foam ring, which will be to do with tuning. I've seen this in a lot of other headphones. I haven't experimented with that, so I'm going to try that on a design in the future, sticking a ring of foam around the driver. But I know the Fostex T50RP and a couple of other ones that I've pulled apart have had a foam ring around. It'd be interesting to see how that affects the tuning. But it's not something I'm going to look at now. This is just a quick and dirty cable replacement. So I'm going to start. I'm hoping this is the obvious thing to do. I'm going to start with the four screws under here. Let's just get those undone. Yeah, I'm going to try and get through this in kind of one take. Let's hope this is pretty straightforward, because I've got loads to do. We've got a backlog of about 100 orders at the moment. We've got that down from about 150, but that's still a lot of cables and headphones and things that need to be made for us to catch up. Normally we run about 40 in the queue, so the queue's a lot longer than it usually is. Come on, give up your secrets. So those four screws are out, but it is not coming out. Should I pull this foam thing off? Anything under there? Ooh, that's some exciting stuff under there. Look at this, let's get this off. Get this unstuck carefully. Okay, I don't want to destroy that. All right, so that's the foam ring, but then you can see under here, look, some other damping material under here. I don't know, these have possibly been modified previously. This doesn't look like the kind of thing that would be factory, but interesting. Oh, I see. Here we go. We're coming apart now. Okay, so the wooden bit comes out the back of this. It was loose the whole time. Alright, let's just pull a bit of the wire through these grommets so we've got a little bit to work with here. Oh, probably don't need the colour chart in there, so my colour game is not on point anyway. Let's just move that out of the way, it's not too distracting. Right, so in here, yeah, so it looks like we have some additional damping material that someone's poked loads of holes in. Interesting. I don't think that is stock. Looks like someone's added that, so that's an interesting little mod that someone's done on those. And we need to get in another layer. So yeah, so as you can see, I've just pulled the cable through the grommet a little bit just to give me a little bit of more leeway. So I can see the screws here. Like, if this isn't I don't think it's factory. But whoever's done it, taking their time over making all these holes. So let's put some love into this. And yeah, it's got a non-standard cable, so these have been pulled apart, and I suspect someone's done some mods. If anyone knows what this mod is, who's doing this mod, let me know. I'd be quite interested to see what that's all about. Yeah, so this is some kind of, I think, bitumen-type damping material, a bit like you get on car dampening, which will absorb vibrations, and then you've got all these holes to let the air back through, so, you know, looks like some love has gone into it. Oh yeah, there we go, it's a big D, so it is Dynamat, it is some car damping material, and it is aftermarket. So you can see they've lined that. We do that on a lot of our headphones, and it helps absorb some of the sound that's bouncing around. inside, in theory. Oh, we got a load more here. So yeah, someone dynamited the hell out of this. Yeah, so just kind of all damped. So here we have the back of the driver, and got one red side, which I assume is positive, and that's negative. I might just stick a multimeter on there and see how they've wired it. Oh, I think they've glued over the top of the wire. Let's see if I can poke through the glue. There we go. 13 ohms. What's this one? 33 ohms. Oh, that is unusual. This must be quite a little bit of... Yeah, I don't know. Perhaps this cable's quite high impedance or something's up, but yeah, it's got about 13 ohms, which is more than I would expect. I'd expect it to be, one or less than one. Let's try the other one. Yeah, that's giving 1.8 ohms to the positive side. I'm not sure why the negative is quite so high. Ah, it's just the glue on there. I've done it on a pad and that's 1.8. Yeah, but anyway, that's confirmed which is positive and which is negative. So now we're going to warm up the soldering iron. Get that on there. But yes, while we were away, we did some... obviously, Christmas and New Year's very busy, but we also had a games company order 100 pairs of gaming headphones, you know, like gaming headsets. And we get contacted quite a lot by people just saying, oh, can I have 100 of this? And it's just because they've got to get 3 quotes. And obviously we're never the cheapest because we do, we're not the cheapest place to get stuff done here in Cheltenham. So I just kind of went like, 100 quid, blah, 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 blah. 100 headphones. Here's your quote. Not expecting to hear anything back. And then they're like, yeah. Carry on, let's do this thing. Oh no, it's Christmas and I've got to make 100 pairs of headphones. So that was a bit annoying. Nice that we get to work on. It was quite an exciting big games release that I'm not allowed to talk about, but it's nice to be asked to do something like that and for them to pay the actual money that we asked, which is good. But yeah, literally, I managed to get COVID at the same time, like on the day that we were supposed to smash these out. I got COVID, off work for 10 days, trying to manage it all from home, but my team were super good, got them out, a little bit late, but, what can you say, over Christmas and New Year, it's always bound to be delays. I'm just being very careful because the voice core wires were attached down here and they've glued this, which is a bit unhelpful. Yeah, it's going to make it dangerous. Just get some of that glue off. Yeah. All right, gluing it, good idea in some ways because it's going to stop the cables from coming away, but it does mean that changing the cable is a bit tricky and dangerous. All right, cool. All right, so we've got the cable off. I'm going to have to clean up that glue carefully in a bit. So this is going to take a bit longer than I thought. As I said, I was hoping to do this in just a nice, easy one take. Ramble on a bit, mod some headphones, but it looks like there's glue everywhere. So they've knotted it and then glued over the top of that. I'm just warming it up with the hot air gun. Should make removing the glue. I wasn't going to do that on the back of the driver because you don't want to get the driver unnecessarily hot if you can avoid it, so I'm hoping I can just kind of pick that glue off. We'll try this. If we can't get this glue off and the knot undone, then I might just snip it. Come on. I can't complain. I'm sure I've hot glued loads of stuff when I've been modding them in the past, and then if someone else comes along and has to mod them after me, they're like, ah! Glue! But that's just the way it is. Alright, cool. Cool, cool, cool. So that's that driver removed. Let's put that somewhere safe. Pull the wire through. Okay, excellent. Right, so now we're just going to rinse and repeat. And let's do that. While I'm doing it, I was going to do just a little speed up on the video, but I won't, because we got some interesting stuff coming up this year, so I'll go through it. We're gonna hopefully do a little event as a treat for the staff. Like, most of us are quite into cars. I have a Mazda RX-8, which I've thrown entirely too much money at. I think I've spent sort of £13,000 on a car that is worth £2,000, but it's my car, you know, it's special. It's got to have all the toys. But yeah, so what we might do is buy a couple more cars. We're going to sell off a load of the headphones that we don't need, because we've got a load of stuff that I've got in for to have a look at, or failed experiments where we've got in headphones to modify and then decided that we just weren't going to go. We weren't going to do that. Yeah, so we've probably got a few £1,000 worth of just random bits and bobs knocking around the office. And, oh, interesting. This one's got longer screws in than the other one had. That's a bit weird. Yeah, so, sorry, what was I saying? Yeah, we're going to hopefully sell all that. I'm going to make a few limited edition things, you know, like one-off pieces. They'll all go into a big sale on eBay or something. We'll get rid of them all and then use that money to buy track cars. And then we're going to go to Wales and race them, or do some kind of challenge. We're thinking of some kind of Top Gear style challenge where we buy cheap cars, drive the Black Mountain Pass in Wales, which is a beautiful, beautiful stretch of road, and then maybe do a track day. Yeah, so it'll be exciting. So if you want to get involved, if you want to, you know, let me know. We're probably going to be doing some kind of sponsorship thing where you can stick your name or your logo on one of the cars. Yeah, so that's quite interesting. And then headphone stuff, I have just managed to get hold of Hi-Fi Man, and they are well up for kind of doing something with us. So we're gonna start stocking their headphones soon. Just undo this. Yeah, so we're gonna start stocking Hi-Fi Man headphones, which is exciting because. Yeah, I modified a pair of those in a previous video, and they came up. I was just really impressed with them, and yeah, they've been very cool about working with this, which is nice. It's a bit difficult sometimes, getting companies on board because we modify their stuff, and there's just, you know, it's understandable. We might cause issues for them by modifying their headphones. So, but yeah, Hi-Fi Man seemed totally cool about it. So I'm going to order in a few of their headphones. We'll get those apart. We'll have a look inside. And yeah, see what you get as you go up the range, that kind of thing. I'm not feeling that rich, so we're not going to get the crazy ones. But yeah, we might get some like 400 or 500 quid ones and see the difference between them and the 200 quid ones. We've also got a balanced amplifier. I haven't had time to work on that, but we have got a balanced amplifier coming out this year. It's nothing magical. It's going to be good value. That's the idea. It's going to cost around 100 quid. We're hoping to do balanced headphones, balanced amp, fancy cables for like 400 or 500 quid if we can, which will be good. Sort of audiophile on a budget. You know, if we can get a kit together which is 400 quid and sounds 1,000 quid, then everyone's a winner. Come on, soldering iron, heat up. Yeah, but yeah, interesting times they are coming. Even though I said we're going to do this in one take, I think we'll obviously skip ahead a bit here because there's going to be a lot of cleaning the glue off and all that kind of stuff. It's pretty boring, not that rock and roll. So yeah, so leave it with me for a bit. I'll get these all cleaned up and then we'll fit the new cable. This is a pretty straightforward job. But yeah, it's interesting to see inside these, how they're made, nicely machined from wood. Personally, I'd give them a bit more lacquer on the wood just to make it extra shiny, but you know, meh. I don't know how much these cost, but I suspect really fancy woodwork is probably unnecessary and just bump up the price. But anyway, let me crack on with these. I'll be back in a bit. Alrighty then. Okay, so that's the original cable removed, and I've cleaned up a lot of the glue off the thing. It's a little bit scary because the glue's right by where the voice coil comes in, and if, I don't know if you've seen my video on the HD25s, but yeah, glue and voice coil wires, they're not friends. You can permanently brick a driver if you're not careful. So I've tested them, both drivers still work at this point, so that's good. We're getting about 24 ohms, which I assume is right, they're both measuring the same. Okay, so as you can see, I'm covered in black schmoo from the damping material. Just carry on. I'll clean up afterwards. Right, so I'm just going to remove the grommets because I reckon it's going to be easier to get this through first and then attach the grommets afterwards. Now then, this cable is obviously a custom-made one, and you've got the shrink tube at the end, and I'm not sure the shrink tube's going to go through here. But we'll see. Just got to figure out which is left and right before I continue. Continue. Let's just do that. Just going to check continuity. Okay, so this one's left. Okay. Which side of this is left? Oh, should have checked that beforehand. Must be that way. Yeah. So that's the left side. Okay, so we want to do the right side first. Okay, so just going to feed the new cable through the hole there. And then hopefully we can get this through the grommet, but we might have to remove the shrink tube and put some new shrink tube on there. Oh no, these are quite stretchy. I reckon that'll be alright. We're out the other side, pretty certain. Let's grab hold of that with the micro manipulators and put it through. So this is my top tip. If you've got these grommety things, like I know a lot of the bear dynamics have them, get your wire through, remove the grommet, put the wire through the hole, and then you can pull it back through and it'll lock into place. Whereas if you try and feed the wire through when it's in there because of the restriction around the circly bit here, you're going to have a bad time. So you'll get a thicker cable through if you do it that way. While I'm doing this, something hilarious happened the other day. We found it hilarious. Like, we're working away in here. You know, we got three guys and a girl. We have a bit of banter. So it's a bit of a sausage fest. We need to get another female employee. We were just chatting away, and I was saying how in the 90s and noughties, people thought that computers were basically magic. And with enough hacking ability, you could pretty much do anything, whereas obviously modern computers aren't like that. So if you look at films like Weird Science, that's what computers were capable of in the 90s. They could make things appear, make women appear from nowhere. And I was just discussing this, saying how 90s computers could make women appear from nowhere and modern computers couldn't. When suddenly this attractive lady appears from nowhere at our stairs and starts asking about Botox. And I'm like, what the, what? And I completely forgot. Two floors down from us, some kind of Botox type clinic has opened up. But yeah, completely threw me out. I'm like, what? What are you? Like, we never have people coming in here. It was just really weird. She'd managed to find herself her way up like three flights of stairs because we're on the top floor. This place is in the basement. And how she got quite so lost, I don't know. But yeah, it was just really weird. At the instant I said, and computers these days can't make women magically appear, suddenly a strange woman magically appeared. It was funny at the time. You had to be there. I don't know. I'm not even going to say what, because she was quite heavily accented. And she said, is this the Botox place? So obviously it sounded like she said, is this the buttocks place? Which I was... threw me even more, and I'm not even going to tell you what James thought she said, but he thought she said something rude. But yeah, it just, yeah, yeah, random. Totes random. Okay, sorry. Right, so we've got these through here. Now we need to get through the hole in the driver. It's not going to go there, is it? It's not going to go there. All right, so I'm going to have to remove the shrink tube, I think. So, yeah, give me a moment. What I'm going to do is I'm going to just heat this up with the heat gun, slit that, pull it off, and then we can feed it through the driver, and we'll put a bit of shrink tube back on again. And I'll also wash my hands because they're getting progressively more black as I keep touching these things. So back in just a minute. All right, cool. All right, so we got the shrink tube off the end. I'm wearing some gloves just to kind of see if I can get less schmoo on me. Yeah, this is probably a bit stickier than the stuff that we generally mod with. That probably means it's better, just because it's gonna sort of absorb sound a bit better if it's a bit squishier. But it does get everywhere. Okay, is that gonna go? It is gonna go. Whoa, just goes. Okay, so we're gonna feed that through there. Down to the driver. I just need a bit more length. Okay, so we've got a bit more room to move. Just double check which is positive. I think blue is negative. Yeah. Yes. Okay. Just warm up the soldering iron. I will probably glue this down again like it was glued before, but I won't glue it right on the solder joints just because I think that's a bit dangerous, possibly. Looking at this bitumen type mod, it's interesting. I can see a slight flaw in the thing. I don't know. So basically bitumen stays fluid, so they've taken a really long time to cut out all the holes to line up with the holes in the baffle. But as you can see, over time it's kind of flowed, and those holes, some of the holes have decreased in size, so where there's pressure on it or it's heated up, the bitumen squished out and started to kind of seal up some of those holes. So it's I don't know, it's probably not a problem, it's just interesting. Yeah, so it's all stuff I'm noting down, because I've considered doing that on the 1990s, cutting the holes in exactly the right place. But having seen it, because this is kind of like a long-term test, this will have been done a couple of years ago probably. And it's interesting to see that it kind of flows into the holes over time if you're not careful. Yeah, so that's that attached. Warm up my glue gun, ready to glue the cable back there in a minute. Boop. Cool. Alright. Let's do the driver on the other side. Okay. Let's move the grommet down a bit more, just to give myself a bit of extra room. We can always move it back up afterwards if we need to. Okay. Wrong way around. Damn. I said I was going to put some more shrink tube on there, but I don't need to. I don't need to. I'll just glue it because it's not preventing it from being pulled through or anything. It's not going to untwist. It'll take up a bit less space inside the ear cap. So again, we're going to positive one first. Okay, so I'm just kind of routing the cable around there. I'm gonna just stick a blob of glue there to stop it from being pulled back through, and I'm just trying to avoid blocking any of these holes that are on here so we don't affect the tuning. Yeah. Yeah, hopefully this all goes back together nicely. So that's soldered in place. Okay. So put this back in there, put that back in there. Happy days. Do these have an up or down? Are they symmetrical? Oh, the grain. Well, probably the grain to go side to side. That goes on there. That doesn't look right, does it? Does it? Does it look right? Hold on, I have to go and have a look at a picture of an original one and see which way the grain goes on there. Should have noted that down first. Didn't think about the grain pattern. Oh, do you reckon these are left and right handed? Do you reckon that's it? Do you reckon there's a... I've got these the wrong way around. Because that still doesn't look right, does it? That looks... That looks even worse. Yeah, I think... this is full of problems that I just wasn't expecting. But, you know, it's just, you never know. You never know. Until you crack on with a job and then you find all kinds of mysteries and secrets. If I ever do another pair of these, I'll know this in the future. Yeah, I think these two wooden panels are different left and right. At a different angle. Okay, so let's try that. Right, how's that gonna look? Oh, that's gonna look right. Yeah. that's where I went wrong. Okay, so yeah, if you're modding a pair of Denon D2000s with wooden ear cups, or I suppose yeah, the other ones have got the names printed on, haven't they? But yes, watch out, they have left and right-handed ones. Right, this screw, I think. Didn't feel like it went down solidly. I think that might have a stripped thread in the wood, but the other three are okay, and it's in, you know, don't know. Yeah, I think that's been over tightened at some point. But let's do something about it. Alright. Alright, let's pull this screw out. Can't get this far and then allow something like that. Okay. Just going to pull this screw out. So essentially there's a thread tapped into the wood, and at some point that screw's been over tightened and pulled the thread out of the wood. So I need to pack that hole with something and then screw it back in. So what I'm going to do is a very thin bit of wire or something is going to go down the side there, and that's just going to help the screw to act a bit like a raw plug in a wall and just separate out and let the screw get tight in there. So I'm just going to have to find a bit of wire, an appropriate bit of wire. Let's use some of this. Gonna remove the gloves just because this is gonna be a delicate operation. So yeah, so basically I've got a bunch of thin wires that I'm gonna stuff down that hole, stick the screw in between them. And that'll just embiggen it slightly. Could have put some glue down there or something like that, but this is this should do the work. Do the job. There we go, that's better. It's better. Yeah, so essentially all the fibres of the wire are sticking up like that. The screw goes down in between and pushes them outwards, jamming up against the sides, and gives it a slightly tighter... It definitely felt like it went tighter that time. and the other screws are all fine. It's going to hold it in place. I'm happy that that's in tight enough now, without me having to mess around with wood glue and stuff like that. Right, cool. Yeah, we've done detachable cable mods on these before, and that's a little bit scary because there's not a lot of room in there. But replacing the cable, pretty straightforward, I think. Most people with no one end of a soldering iron from the other could do this. So I'm going to get this one side in, and then we'll check to make sure that the wire isn't twisted, because that'll be a bit of a nightmare. Because it always kind of, yeah, it won't lie nicely if the cable, if one cable's twisted. So we'll just check that in a second before we put the rest of them together. Okay, so we have one ear cup in. Happy days. Yeah, I think I'm going to have to open that driver, untwist that. I just should have done that before. Yeah, I didn't think about it till just now. But I don't think I can untwist that without removing the other driver. Yeah, so I'm going to have to get in there, twist it. There. Let's do this side. This side isn't twisted. Yes, modding anything for the first time. Like, these aren't our cables, not used to using them. Don't normally do these headphones, and it's just always interesting. You know, you start off and you're thinking, yeah, this is a 10-minute job. One take on a video, no problem. See, pretty soon, you know, it's an hour. but it's interesting. You get to learn some stuff. It's always fascinating. You know, I'm hoping to gear up and design my own headphones this year, probably. I've got some novel technologies that we can put in it. I've been having a look at some stuff because you need your own shtick. Yeah, so we're going to have some kind of proprietary technology in there. I'm hoping, my aim, if I'm going to design a couple of pairs of headphones. One of them is going to be just a nice looking, well made pair of headphones, you know, with a bit of design flair, which will sound good. The other ones will look horrendous, but yeah. But I'm trying to emulate the sound of listening to speakers when you listen to headphones, and I'm trying to do that in an analog way, you know, not with DSPs and things like that. I'm just going to try and do it by modifying the enclosure and the way the sound is delivered to the ears. Which is it's an interesting project. It's going to be quite a long project though, and it might not work out. I don't know. There's probably a reason why no one's done it the way I'm thinking of doing it. But we will have to see. But yeah, every pair of headphones that I pull apart, I learn a little something. And I hope that goes, I learn good practices and bad practices as I go along. Oh man, this one doesn't want to go in the hole. I might have to use a bit of PTFE to get that in. So I'm just going to wrap it in PTFE tape, which should help me pull it through, hopefully. I'm just rambling away, failing to pull a grommet through a hole. But hey, we get to hang out. It's nice. As I said, missed you guys. Working so hard over Christmas and New Year and COVID-y and just the whole thing's been a bit mad. I can't wait to get back to just chilling out a bit and getting to design some stuff rather than making hundreds of pairs of headphones. Don't get me wrong, it's good from a bank balance point of view. You know, I'm just gonna go towards buying our race cars, Team Custom Cans race team. We might. There we go, so the grommet's through, basically. Yeah, I'm not sure 100% what we're going to do. But yeah, definitely we're going to buy at least one car. I've got the RX-8, which is pretty much, you know, pretty sorted. It's got fancy suspension, it's got all the mods you could want to do for reliability. I should be able to bounce that off the 10k rev limiter all day without it exploding. Hopefully, because I will be. I think that's it. You know, I'm just obsessed with sound. The reason I got the RX-8, partially because, like, from an engineering point of view, it's really good. It's got good weight balance, all that kind of stuff. You know, so it's a, but it hasn't got enough power to actually kill me. But yeah, the main reason I bought it is because when I was a child, I used to play with toy cars a lot, and I would, you know, I'd make the sound, you know, the sound as I'm pushing it along, make the engine sound, and the RX-8 sounds like that noise I used to make as a child. Let's cut in a clip. This is just not great footage, but basically, this is what it sounds like when it's singing the songs of my people. Yeah, so just, that's terrible. That was picking it up on the mic on the GoPro. In real life, it's pretty incredible. Yeah, but when we do this trip, we'll take fancy microphones and stuff with us, and we'll get decent videos of the cars. And we're hoping, I think, just to kind of tie it in, because obviously we're all just into cars, but we work in the audio kind of industry. We're hoping to tie it in by maybe the other cars that we buy. We might try and get another one that sounds interesting. Thinking like a Golf VR6 or something. I mean, is that the grain look right? Grain looks right, yeah. But yeah, so we're going to try and find some interesting sounding cars, race them up a Welsh mountain, and then down a Welsh mountain. I think there's a toge event that we might enter, or we might do a hill climb. It'll be cool, especially like as these cars we will not care about, because they will be cheap eBay jobbies, and we'll drive until they go pop. And if they don't go pop, that's it, we'll sell them. But yeah, should be a good adventure. But I'm definitely, like, unfortunately, the RX-8, I was parked out here, I was just dropping off some bits, and I was involved in a car crash. Basically, a BMW piled into the back of this SUV, which then punted it into the back of my car, which caused this. It's got a slightly bruised bottom there. Bent the exhaust, had a bad time, and unfortunately the insurance people wanted to write it off. So I've spent since November, it's been off the road, and it's cost me several thousand pounds to put back together, but hopefully it'll be back, and yeah, I can listen to those glorious triangles again. But anyway, here we are. I got a little, just a slight twist in this one, so I'm gonna undo that, but that's basically it. There we go. So we've recabled some Denon D2000s. I suspect it'll be a lot easier than that if you do them. The damping material and stuff in there has made it a bit difficult. I'm going to have to clean off some of this. It's got a little bit of shmoo on there. But yeah, it's pretty straightforward. No booby traps in there, really. The only thing we've got to look out for is if you've got the grain on here, you know, get that lined up. And they are left and right handed, it turns out. But there you go. It's been fun hanging out, and I hope you join us on our adventures later in the year. Anyway, if you've got any questions, stick them in the thing, and then, yeah, I've got a few more things that people have sent in for me to fix or repair or stuff, and I'll try and get some videos of those, because yeah, we're just so busy, so I'm trying to combine paid jobs and videos at the moment, so we'll be making a few cables, modding a few headphones that people are turning in, that kind of stuff, over the next couple of months until everything calms down, and then we'll go back to maybe doing some design reviews, that kind of thing. All right, cheers, great hanging out. Whoop, 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 whoop.